In this job, we're gonna see again from the cell scripting module, but I want to see you should know how to use your Maven from the system itself. I will just download Maven. You already know how to use and install Maven, right? Let's go to Maven site. Quickly download this file. And let's do duplicate here. So I'm just extracting Maven for the installation, and once Maven is installed, so let's rename it. You can rename any Apache, Java, anything, right, that we have if you want. Just to define the home, it will become easy for you. So let's navigate to the bin. Yep, we have bin directory and we have one mvn command available here. So let's define the home. So either you can do here or you know that everything, right? So I don't need to explain anything now. So I will export it mvn underscore path. I will call it home. Right, so I will export it again. Path equals to dollar. MVN underscore home slash bin colon dollar path. Right, so looks good. It's MVN underscore home bin dollar path. Sounds good. So let's do source slash etc profile, and if C Maven is working, that should be working. Let's try it from outside. Okay, Maven is working fine. But last time, guys, you have seen one issue, right? When you would be doing, whenever any tool is executing any command from I mean from some tool, it gets bit difficult sometime to write. What it try to do is it try to check the Maven, where is Maven, and it at this moment you see Maven is being called from this location if I did the Maven, right? But when we are executing command from the any tool, it try to check the Maven in slash bin Maven and it doesn't find Maven. So in that case we get some issue like the Maven is not available in our system, but however we have Maven available, right? In such a case we have some workaround on that. So you can create the soft link on this, right? And you can make it bin Maven, right? So let's validate now bin Maven. You will see the Maven should be there as a soft link, I think. So sorry, my bad. So what I need to do is you just need to create one soft link which says this is the Maven, this is the absolute path of Maven, and just I'm creating the soft link out of that. So if you do ls-l here, now you can see the Maven is there. Now if you try which Maven, so the Maven is here itself, but we have also available Maven in the bin Maven. Right, now we will not get any issue even if we are executing the command from the remote. So let's go to Jenkins again. So what we are doing in this job is we are saying, okay, this is my repository, and instead of doing this, what I will do here now is mvn clean install. So what I'm doing now, I'm using shell scripting module, which you can see here. So anytime you can use multiple modules from here, right? You can also use the execute shell. Instead of like doing it from some of the module, you can do it from the here shell directly. What's the issue? And whatever you want to do, right? If you click here, you will see the list of variable that you can use in the Jenkins. right? Branch name, change ID, URL, and these variable are pretty useful for you guys. So make sure you know you have like you go through these things, right? So now you can try apply and save this and go ahead and do a quick build. So this time, instead of taking your Maven from the GUI itself, your Maven will be directly picked up from your system. Do you see now? The execution has been successfully completed, right? Started by Chandrasekhar, and this is the workspace. And now, if you see from where the Maven is running, so you can see checkout is done here. Do you see that? Maven clean install, it directly ran. Earlier, it used to run from the tool, but now it directly ran from your system. Right? So sometime if you need it from your server itself, directly install it, define the home, and you can execute it from here. Right? So now you are done with this. Again, you have one another method, like if you are creating the jobs, right? But what you want is, instead of writing this in the shell script, right? Let's say I close it, I go to build section, I do top level Maven targets, right? Instead of selecting any Maven from the Jenkins itself, I will say call it default and we'll use mvn clean install. Let's say do clean install itself. And let's go ahead and do the build. And see the logs. Again, see from where the Maven was picked up. Maven clean install. It was directly taken from your system. Instead of we picked it from some like a Jenkins integrated tool. Now, so I have already explained you about how we can use deployment using the shell scripting module. So we'll go down and we'll remove this and we'll go ahead and use the execute shell script mvn clean install. Now once you know your job is done, your job is built, you know our dollar workspace variable would be created. You can navigate to the cd dollar workspace, right? Inside the workspace, what you will have, so let's go to the root dot Jenkins, right? Inside the workspace, your first job, this we build here, right? So by default, this path will be automatically taken till here, right? Even if you want to validate it, what you can do is echo dollar workspace. If you want to print something, if you want to validate it as well, so you are just printing it after you are doing the build. So apply and save. And let's do after one thing also after this. And you wanna run ls-ltr. Apply, save. Just run the build. So why I'm telling this is, this can be useful for you. Sometimes you do not have access to server, but you have your Jenkins access, and Jenkins is running with some specific users. So you can see now it tells us what is the dollar workspace is. Dollar workspace is till your job name, right? Inside it, you can see this is the path, right? Target and other things. So I will again go back to the job. We'll click on configure. If I want to run some deployment from the, I want to do deployment from here, what I can do simply now. Now I can cd dollar workspace, or I can do scp hyphen r wherever I want to copy it. Let's say I'm going to copy to my remote node from here. Let's say to my dev node. Let's take the public IP here. Whatever the user you have, what exactly you want to copy? Dollar workspace slash, we have one target folder also. Inside this target folder, star.var. So I do not want to give the complete var name, right? Root at the rate, put it here. I mean IP, sorry, I will get it from this node. Let's go to this, put it here inside your OPT and Apache Tomcat. So path is same, so I'm just taking from my master node itself, Apache Tomcat and web apps. This is my path in the remote directory also. So I'm gonna take this. So what I'm doing here is I'm just doing it from here. If you want to write something like starting and stopping something, you can use SSH module here, as I mean SSH command hyphen T and whatever you want to restart, stop and do the things, right? Let's go ahead and apply and save. Right, I think it's better for me to give the private IP instead of giving this public IP. So I will grab the private IP here. Can I see that public IP, private IP? I cannot see that, no worry. So it may be like I do not have access to that, so I'll validate it first.
Private IP
is saved. Let's do SSH from the public IP, at least we come to know. Okay, we will need to create the password as SSH. Right, so I think you know further things. I will just quickly do the deployment, even if that goes fail, but I know you understand this, you'll be able to do that, right? You just need to apply the build. So instead of doing this, I will quickly deploy it to my local machine because I don't want to waste time in doing SCP things, right? So I'm doing then CP, right? You can do SCP here. So what I will do is I will quickly deploy it to my local Apache Tomcat itself. I will quickly apply and save it and build this. So this is how you can use. You can see the build has been successfully completed and the deployment is successfully done. I did it just in my local system for the testing. So make sure you are just doing practice for your remote systems, right? So this is how you can use your own system Maven and this shell module, right, also for the build and deployment. This may be very, very useful for you.